Ain't life groovy with Lucinda away? Hey!
Nice attitude for a stockholder, Kirk.
Did you have a nice time with Link yesterday?
Mm-hmm. We went riding and he stayed for dinner.
And then? And then? Come on, Connor, I want details, details!
I think my secretary's back. I need to reschedule one of my appointments with a client.
Darryl Crawford?
Yeah, I wish. I haven't even heard from him. You know, I was really hoping to have him sign before Lucinda gets back.
Well, you have a few more days. I'm sure she's going to stay down in Montego for Sierra's birthday, which is tomorrow.
Always thinking.
Yes, hello, Ellie Snyder. Kirk Anderson here. Yes, you did, and it was the longest 20 minutes of my life. Well, you know, it's funny you say that, because the pressure's off right now, because Lucinda's still in the Southern Hemisphere, so I'm going to take advantage of every last lovely moment to just kind of, oh, I don't know.
Hey, baby, what are you doing in this office? I gave it to Connor for her use. Get your high heels off my desk.
I'm going to avoid Susan as much as is humanly possible, and I've told her that. I thought you'd be happy about the choice I made.
I would be a lot happier about it if I thought your heart was in it. But you're not happy about this, are you?
I know that I hurt her, but it's done. The choice is made. Isn't that enough for you?
You don't understand, Barclay. That's an order. After our meeting with Miss Jameson, you're going to England.
I told you. I'm not going anywhere.
All right. My attorney will contact the district attorney, and I'll have you charged with embezzling company funds.
And I'll have to explain why I did it. Explain why my sister needed the money to be free of you, to get away from your abuse.
You won't do that. You know what that would do to Angel. We both love her too much.
Don't you talk to me about how much you love her. You used her for your own sick needs. She may never get over what you did to her in the name of love.
You have never understood.
I understand this. That you're never going to go near her again because I won't let you.
If you go to the police, Angel will deny everything.
I'm afraid that doesn't matter. There's someone else who's very eager to tell them what they know.
Holden has no proof of anything.
I'm not talking about Holden. Caleb knows the whole story now. Angel told him that he's not the one who got her pregnant. That she had to go to that butcher for an abortion because she was carrying your baby.
Caleb! Caleb, please, we've got to talk.
Angel, are you okay? Look, I'm just going to see Cal, all right?
I don't believe you.
Angel, you can...
Hey. Angel told me that, Dr. Stewart called about Julie.
Yeah, Emily thinks she's in L.A. I'm going to go and tell Cal to let his detectives know.
Caleb.
Angel, you can come with me if you'd like.
Well, I was hoping that Angel and I could spend a little time together this morning. Hmm?
All right, well, then I will see you two later.
Okay, give Cal my best.
I will.
I'm going to make you some nice, fresh blueberry pancakes for breakfast.
Brought to you today by Era Detergent. Era reigns over stains.
Nobody's gonna break my stride. Nobody's gonna slow me down. Oh no, I got to keep on moving.
You
love life too much to let any of it pass you by. That's why you wear a Tims. A Tims doesn't fasten low at the hips, it fastens higher at the waist to help it stay in place and protect you snug and secure.
Nobody's gonna slow me down. Oh no, I got to keep on moving.
When I grow up, I want to be a track star.
No one ever says, I want to be a junkie when I grow up. Don't let drugs get in the way of your dreams.
Painful sore throat and no Chloraseptic spray? That's okay. Chloraseptic lozenges actually work like this spray to penetrate nerve endings and stop pain fast. Great tasting Chloraseptic lozenges. Fast relief when you're away from your spray.
If you're counting calories, here's something you should know. An entire Kellogg's Special K breakfast, including cereal, fruit, skim milk, and coffee, actually has fewer calories than the leading diet shake. Fewer calories, and when you're dieting, isn't that what's important? Kellogg's Special K. Lose the fat.
Yes, it is. I'll talk to you later. Welcome back.
Oh, what are you
good
doing
to see you.
In here? Yes. I thought I gave Connor the use of
it. That's right. You did. I was just keeping the seat warm for her. She happened to step out for a minute.
Thank you.
I didn't expect to see you quite so soon.
Well, you certainly didn't expect me to spend the rest of my life in Montego.
No, I just knew that Sierra's birthday was tomorrow.
Oh, we celebrated it last night. It was so wonderful. And then she had to go off on some damn political trip. She took the baby, so
it's great to see you.
Hi, darling. It's
I'll clear myself out of here right away.
No. No rush. How are things going with Mr. Lane?
I am right on top of it. I'm meeting him today at the Lakeview this afternoon.
Wonderful. No, darling, don't make it at Lakeview. Make it here at noon. I want to be in on this. Okay. Oh, Gavin Kruger, we are going to polish off Kruger's furniture division with Lang.
Jane, yes. I would like you to get Duncan McKechnie on the phone, please. I wish to discuss my real estate venture with him.
Duncan's out of town.
Invaluable input from Mr. Anderson. Thank you very much. Hey.
Okay, just leave a message at the Argus.
All right, you know why I'm excited?
Why?
Because I've discussed the whole thing with Craig, and he wants to come in as a partner with me.
Lucinda!
Oh, Holden, I'm back, and we had so much to talk about.
Yes, we do, like those two new accounts that I landed.
Wonderful. But first things first, I want to know how Lily is. And don't you dare tell me you don't know.
I'm afraid that what you are saying is that you're giving in to what I want. But it's not your choice.
But it is my choice. I'm going to avoid Susan as best I can, even though I work in the same hospital with her. I thought that would prove to you how much I want our marriage to be back on track.
How do you expect me to feel when I can see, obviously, how miserable you are?
Because I know I hurt Susan. Maybe that shows weakness to you.
Come on now, you know that's not true.
Look, I'm not up for an argument. You know, if we're going to pursue this thing, I think we better get Matt to act as a referee.
Why are you so angry?
I'm not angry, I'm just frustrated. I thought this would make you happy. I thought I'd taken a step in the right direction. Instead, you've turned it into...
You're right. I'll call Matt and see if we can get an appointment. Okay.
Why can't you understand how I feel about you? I love you and I need you more now than I ever have.
I love you too. That has never been the problem.
Well, if we have these feelings for each other, why can't...
Kim!
Oh. Hi.
Sorry, I didn't mean to interrupt. I didn't know you were here. I just came by to say good morning.
Well, don't let me stop you. I've got to get to the hospital. You will call?
I will. I'll call you back. Listen, thank you for coming back. John.
I'm sorry. I'm sorry. He usually has Chris to school by this time, though, you know?
I know. He usually does. He took him earlier and he came back to talk.
Well, that's good then, isn't it? Isn't it?
He told Susan that he thinks it would be best if they made an attempt to stop seeing one another.
Well, good. Isn't that what you wanted? Say, listen, what's the problem?
He did it to please me, and I appreciate that. But it's not his choice. Oh, God. I could forgive, and I could forget the whole thing if I thought that he truly wanted to stop seeing Susan, but he doesn't. And I don't want him back, knowing he feels so deeply about her. I don't know. I guess I expect too much.
No, I don't think that you do. I said it before. I think you deserve everything.
All right, well, we can discuss that at the meeting later. Connor, over. No. No, not now. All right, I'll see you then.
Well, Dad?
What do you want me to say? The idea that it was my child is so preposterous.
Stop lying, Dad. Angel told me the story herself.
Barkley. I know that you love your sister, but you know that she is emotionally unstable. She imagines things.
She's sticking to reality much better than you are right now. You're in danger. Caleb is looking for you. Angel asked me to warn you.
Then she can't hate me as much as you claim. Besides, I'm not afraid of Caleb Snyder.
You should be. Don't you remember what you did to him? You and Jay and Steven beat him. What were you punishing him for? For defiling your innocent daughter that you loved? Can you imagine how he feels when he found out that it was your baby and that you knew it from the start and that you were using him to cover your own guilt?
That's enough.
Listen to me. Please. Angel has a chance to live a decent life if she can just get the help she needs, and I'll see that she gets it. I want you to go to London. You can still run the corporation from there, but you're not to have anything more to do with Angel. Do you understand me? If you don't do what I say, I will have to go to the authorities and report you, and you are the one who will go to jail, not me.
I've never run from anything in my life. I am not about to start now.
Caleb has a gun. If he finds you, Dad, it may be too late to run.
When you keep that shower fresh feeling with Bam, you feel good about yourself. How do people see you? Too young to go gray? You could cover it with Loving Care, the hair color that's as gentle to the hair as a shampoo. Really, is there a choice? Gray hair or Loving Care?
Remember the last time you microwaved chicken with breadcrumbs? Introducing French's Microwave Mixes. They're made just for your microwave to seal in the juices better than breadcrumbs, so you make tender, juicy chicken in delicious flavors like Italian Parmesan. One taste and you'll bounce the rubber chicken forever. New French's Microwave Mixes, the best way to microwave chicken.
Great. No GE soft whites.
Well, so I'll try one of these.
With an ordinary bulb, you get something you don't get with a GE Soft White. Glare. Maybe that's why GE Soft White's America's favorite bulb. Because once you've got GE's almost 100% reliability and soft, warm, glowing light, you won't let anybody change your light bulb. Because GE is light.
New Allied attacks on Iraqi positions. Watch the latest reports from the front lines tonight on a special edition of the CBS Evening News with Dan Rather.
Angel, we can't hide out forever. Somehow I gotta find the guts to stand up to Dad, get us out of this nightmare we've been in ever since we were kids. If I can, and if I see this Dr. Michaels and start therapy, will you come with me?
Oh.
finished your breakfast. Now you have to eat.
I'm sorry. Holden is always saying that to me, too.
Well, you know he's right. He is right. You need your energy.
I just don't know how he can be so concerned about me after all that I've put him through.
Because he cares about you. And he wants the best for you. Can I tell you something? My Holden has changed a lot since he's known you. He's become more aware, more sensitive to other people's feelings. And I have you to thank for that.
I just feel so bad for coming between him and Lily.
Well, you mustn't. You know, the way they've come together to help you in this crisis has made them both very strong, and they both can be very self-centered people. And I think this has changed them.
Well, I guess I had a good effect on somebody.
You have to remember something. You never hurt anyone. It was the other way around. You're very young. And you've got your whole life ahead of you. And it's going to be very different from the past.
When you say it, I can almost believe it.
Well, you better believe it, because it's true. And you never caused this unhappiness. And you do have the power to change it. And you can begin by talking to someone who can help you.
Oh, you mean therapy, but I can't. See, I can't talk to a stranger about this.
Just a minute. You talk to me, and you talk to Ida, and we both understood. Now, doesn't it make sense that if you talk to somebody who's used to dealing with these problems, that they'll not only understand, but they can really help you? Doesn't that make sense? Look at those beautiful pancakes I'm going to feed to my piggies. Ooh, they're going to love you.
I cannot believe that Lucinda is back.
Well, you should have heard Kirk. His voice went up 3 octaves when she walked into the office. It was terrible.
Hey, listen,
hey. Yeah, he's across the hall with Link. They should be here in just a minute.
Come here. Are you all right?
Yeah.
I was worried about you last night.
I'm
you seem very uptight.
I'm okay.
Lily told me that Julie called Lisa. Is that true?
Oh, sorry, Caleb. Sorry.
Hey, how you doing?
Hello, ladies. Hello. Cal, listen. Emily called Susan and seems to think that Julie's in L.A., all right?
Well, that's good. I'll tell my detective. Let him know that.
I don't get it. If Julie's out on the coast, why doesn't she try to see her kids?
Well, I'll tell you, you know, she may not know that her kids are with Frank's mom in Seattle. Listen, I'm going to stop by the farm later. You got time to go over the books?
No, I don't. I have some things I need to do in town, all right? I don't know when I'll be back.
Okay, let's take off, Link. Ladies, yeah. You find me a good spokesman for Stricco, okay?
You're see you later, Caleb.
Hello, Lucinda.
Hello, nice to meet you. Oh, hello, Caleb. Hi.
Hi.
Hi, honey. I'm back. Oh, honey. Oh,
you look great. How's
Thank
Sierra?
You. Oh, she's so wonderful, and they're all so happy. That boy, he takes after his father. He's just so sexy.
Oh,
he knows
this
how
is
to
wonderful. Listen, I I didn't mean to open the floodgates. I don't have time right now. I'm swamped.
Oh,
but
yeah,
can we have
yeah.
lunch?
Yes, lunch. It has to be late lunch, though, because I got a 12 noon meeting in my office with Henry Lang.
How are you?
Good to see you.
Introducing a new idea in air freshening, Glade Country Pottery.
Put out the pottery. Put it here, put it there.
Simple, handmade pieces of glazed pottery.
Put it
porous clay releases the light, fresh scent for 30 days.
Just to put out the pottery, put the fresh country air everywhere.
Put out the pottery, new Glade Country Pottery.
Sure, I want my family to eat healthy. Doesn't everyone? But I can still cook foods we love. I just cook them smarter. And I trust Pam to help me do that.
Even healthy foods like chicken can be loaded with fat and calories cooked in butter, margarine, or oil. Look at all the fat and calories they add compared to Pam, the healthier choice.
That's why we're Pam people. When they eat healthy, I'm happy.
No Stick Pam Cooking Spray. It's the healthier way to cook.
I get this awful sinus pain.
These sinus pain formulas all made news in the 80s. They all have the same medicine. Today's news is Tristan Sinus, the only sinus medicine with ibuprofen.
It relieves my sinus pain wherever it strikes.
New Tristan Sinus.
Why do I enjoy healthier Alpine Lace, low cholesterol and low sodium Swiss low cheese? Because it tastes so good. And now it's even lower in fat.
The healthy and tasty Swiss low cheese
tastes so good
from Alpine Lace.
Thursday.
I made you the Flash.
She had the mind to create him. Now she has the power to destroy him.
I can speed him up. I can slow him down.
My God, what have they done to me?
I can let him live. Or I can make him die.
Flash, watch out!
Tina, no!
The Flash, Thursday.
All in the Family 20th Anniversary Special, Saturday.
Okay, thanks very much, Matt. I'm going to have to check with Bob, but I'm pretty sure we can make it. Fine. Thanks again. Bye-bye. Come in.
Hi.
Hi.
My secretary says we have a meeting with Mr. Strickland this morning.
Yeah, we do. Ooh, he should be here any minute.
Okay. Kip, I was wondering if you'd like to have dinner with me some night soon. You know, we never get a chance to talk about anything but business around here.
Oh. Well, Jeff, thanks very much, but I try to keep my evenings for Christopher. Actually, that's not the only reason. Even though Bob and I are separated, I'm not comfortable with the idea of... Well, I mean, business is one thing, but I don't date.
Okay. I understand. But if you ever change your mind...
Cal, hi, come on in.
How are you?
Glad to see you. Thanks for joining us. You remember Jeff Talbot?
Of course. New Year's, right?
Right.
Yeah, good to see you again, Jeff.
Same here.
Please, sit down.
We were just discussing the possibility of you doing an interview on Heart of the City.
Well, I personally have some misgivings about it because I'm... like my privacy, and I think a man ought to be known by his works rather than what he says, but... Ellie Snyder and Link Lafferty have been working on me, and though I confess I have never seen Heart of the City, I'm going to do it.
Well, you won't regret it, I promise you.
Seth's standing in the studio. Why don't we go down there? I'll show you around and explain how things work.
Good.
Listen, would you two mind going on ahead? I'll catch up with you. I do have a phone call tonight.
Okay, fine. We'll be in the studio.
Fine.
Sit out here to the right.
All right.
Hi, it's Kim Hughes calling. I'd like to speak to my husband. Would you page him for me, please? Yes, I did want you to agree to avoid seeing Susan whenever possible. But I'd feel a lot better if you weren't so unhappy about it.
Bob, look, I want to apologize for barging in on you and Kim this morning.
Have you decided to move in with Duke permanently?
No, I am. I'm looking for a place of my own. As a matter of fact, maybe I can rent Blake's apartment. I understand from Kim you may not be using it that much longer.
Excuse me.
Boy, you're a hard man to find.
Oh, I got your message. What's up?
Look, I'm very worried about Emily. I want to fly out to L.A. and see her. So if you could give me a few days' leave.
Yeah, sure. Take as long as you want.
And don't come back, huh?
I didn't say that, did I? I want you to come back. You know I want you to come back.
Look, a few weeks ago, you were pretty adamant about my taking that job in California for Kim's sake.
I was thinking about you just as much as I was about Kim. I knew you would be hurt if you stuck around here, and from what I hear, my guess is right.
Well, look, why don't you meet me here, and then maybe we can have lunch before we go to Matt's office. All right, bye-bye.
I was right, wasn't I?
I guess Kim told you, right? She's probably happy.
No, she's not really happy.
I don't want to talk about it.
Listen,
Thanks for the news.
Don't blame it all on me, will you, okay? Just don't take it all out on me.
I'll talk to you before I leave. Good morning.
Hi.
Gee, hello.
I didn't know you were back.
I just got back.
Good.
I just got back. I thought I'd drop by and see how you are.
Oh, I'm okay. Here, look.
Oh,
you look fine.
Thank you.
Is You look as well as the last time I saw you.
Ah.
You know.
Yes, let's forget all about the Dominican Republic except the things we have to remember.
Right. So how's Sierra?
She's wonderful. Wonderful. They all are, and they love me.
Good.
And they hate you. Because you divorced me.
I see. You heard from Lily?
I went by. I saw her first thing.
Good.
She's busy. Very busy. Didn't have time for me. I guess she's only got quality time for Holden.
Don't get involved in that, okay?
Oh! Shh. Please, please, darling. We're divorced.
Now, wait a minute. Wait a minute. Lily is in love with this boy. That does not mean that she does not have room in her life for you. You know that. You've got to stop looking at Holden as if he's a threat to you.
Now. Sorry. Sorry, I just have an appointment. Sorry, I can't chat. I've got to run.
You don't want to listen.
Hey, take care of yourself.
You, you too.
There's been a change of plans, Virginia. I'll be going to London later today. No. Barclay won't be going. Would you please get Mr. Victor Symington on the phone and have him call me here? No, I'll explain to him later. Thank you. Operator, this is Henry Lang, 901. In addition to Miss Jameson and my son Barclay, I will also accept calls from my attorney, Victor Symington. All right, thank you. Well, you've won.
Do you really think that I consider this a victory? Do you know what this has done to me? Can you imagine how it made me feel not to be able to help? I was so weak, so afraid of you. You're my father. I wanted to respect you like James. They're lucky that they don't know.
I want your word. They never will.
I won't tell them. But you better be prepared. If Angel goes into therapy, this could all come out. I don't think that she'll ever be whole again until she's honest about how she suffered and who is responsible.
I want you to look after your sister.
You don't have to ask me that.
And will you please try to explain to her that I do love her? I have always loved her.
No. How could I explain that, Dad? When you love someone, you don't hurt them, and you have hurt Angel. You've almost destroyed her. You robbed her of so many things, including any sense of self-respect. She's gonna have to see that. If she's ever gonna get over this and stop blaming herself.
Well, I better get ready for my trip.
Why? Why? Find a way to make me understand.
Tears are very unbecoming in a man, Barclay. I think you better go.
Are you gonna be all right? I hope that you get help yourself. I wanted to love you. I wanted to be a good son to you. I wanted all of us to be happy, Angel and Mama. Why did you do it?
Goodbye, son. Dry your eyes before someone sees you. I warned you, Angel. I told you no one else could ever understand. Hello? Oh, Victor, thank you. Thank you for getting back to me so quickly. I have an emergency here in Oakdale. I need you to come down here right away. Yes, I would. I want to fixate some changes in my will. And I want you to bring that revision with you so it can be executed before I leave for London later today. Yes, I am upset. My life has been threatened. A young hothead named Caleb Snyder used to work for me. No, I don't want the police involved in this. All right, now. These are the changes I want in the will.
Touchstone Pictures presents Bette Midler and Woody Allen.
Well, look at you.
Together at last, proving there's room in a marriage for many wonderful and intimate things.
I love you.
But the truth...
I had an affair.
...is not one of them.
Ah, you are the most callous, selfish, short-sighted...
You sure?
I hope you fry in hell!
Scenes from a mall.
Did she do tricks in bed, things I don't do?
No. Yes, actually, she did.
Rated R. Starts Friday, February 22nd at a theater near you.
What pain reliever do doctors recommend most for minor arthritis pain, backaches, sprains and strains, and menstrual pain? Advil. Gentler to your stomach than aspirin, safe, trusted, doctor recommended. Advil, advanced medicine for pain.
Cut! Great cake!
Maybe for you, but my hemorrhoids are killing me.
Try Citagen.
Still going. Nothing outlasts the Energizer. They keep going and going.
We'll continue with part two of As the World Turns in just a moment.
Tonight, they thought the good times would never end. They were wrong.
Will I be one of those homeless people?
Hard times. They could be yours. Watch 48 Hours. Then.
I need to report another murder. Mine.
If your days were numbered...
Radioactive iodine.
Would you make your killer pay?
This isn't the way!
Jake and the Fat Man, tonight.
This is CBS.
Get the exclusive inside story on one of Europe's most popular enduring sex goddesses, Sophia Loren, on Entertainment Tonight.
Catch the stars tonight at 7 on TV6. Then stay tuned for Family Feud at 7:30. It's TV's hottest hour.
From Lancome Laboratories comes Extraordinary Oligo Major, a serum formulated with essential minerals used daily. A few drops will help your skin function more efficiently, fortifying it to a renewed clarity and a smoother texture. It puts your skin in control of the elements. Oligo Major. No skin can afford to be without it. Lancome, Paris.
Sacré Superbe, your gift with any $15 Lancome purchase.
At participating Leggett stores.
Bring your kids to Captain D's, and you don't need to bring much money, because with an adult purchase, kids eat free all day. Treat your kids without biting into your family budget at Captain D's, the great little seafood place. Captain D's Great Big Shrimp Sale, featuring the new lightly battered shrimp dinner, the bite-sized shrimp dinner, and the Big Ten shrimp dinner. Just $3.99 each during the Great Big Shrimp Sale at the Great Little Seafood Place, Captain D's.
Court is back in session, weekdays at 4 on TV6.
Now part 2 of As the World Turns.
Connor, you set up that meeting with Henry Lyon?
Yeah, he's coming at noon today.
Well, I'll be back by then.
No need. I know it's an awkward situation for you.
All the same, tell him I need to speak to him.
What's the matter? You upset because you have to get out of the big office?
No, that's not it.
Link Lafferty's here to see you.
Oh, thanks, Jane. Show him in.
All right, that's my cue to get out of here.
No, don't. There's something I need to discuss with you.
Hey, how you doing?
Hi, Link. What's up?
I just thought I'd check in our plans for dinner at that Mexican place.
I'm sorry, that's out. Lucinda got back early, and I need to work late tonight.
Well, just tell her you already made plans.
I can't do that.
Okay, how about tomorrow?
Tomorrow. Can you give me a call?
Sure. Do you have time now for coffee?
No, Link, I've got to prepare for a meeting right now.
Sorry I bothered you.
Bye.
Gee, and I thought you liked the guy.
I do.
And why'd you treat him like something that was stuck to your shoe?
What, did I seem unfriendly?
Well, unfriendly, indifferent, couldn't care less. Take your pick.
Well, I didn't intend to. Look, I like him a lot. I'm just busy right now, all right? Barkley, I'm glad you're here. We need to go over those projections before the meeting this afternoon.
Is Holden here?
Oh, no, he just left to go to Lily's office.
Thanks. I'll find him there.
What, you're coming to the meeting, aren't you?
I don't know.
Gee, Caleb, why don't you take your jacket off and stay a while?
I'm fine.
Caleb, what the hell is going on here now? Talk to me.
Did you even have to ask? Julie calls Lisa. She doesn't say anything about coming back. She doesn't even say she wants to talk to
me. No, it's something more than that. That's why I insisted on you having coffee with me. Now, you tell me what it is, because maybe I can help you.
No. It's something I have to handle all by myself.
Handle what, Caleb? Why does my intuition tell me that this has something to do with Angel? Now, I know you feel guilty about that
You're
abortion.
You're damn right I feel guilty. And Henry Lang had his sons beat me up just to make sure of that. Then they roughed you up to drive the point home.
Caleb, I let go of that a long time ago, and so should you.
And I'm not going to. Look, I gotta get out of here, all right?
No. Caleb!
I'm sorry what I said to Lucinda sent her over here.
No, I'm glad that you're honest with her.
Did she give you a hard time?
She didn't have the time. Did you hear from Barkley?
No. I just hope that he can stand up to Henry this time, though.
I believe that he's going to. It's just got to be pretty hard for him. It can't be easy to turn your father into the authorities, no matter what he's done.
As long as he gets Henry to agree to leave the country and stay away from Angel, everything will be fine. I'm going to call Angel. I'm going to see if she heard from Barkley.
Yeah, the waiting's got to be harder for her than any of us.
You know, I have a meeting with Henry Walsh at noon.
Hello?
Mama, hi, it's Holden. I just wanted to call and see how Angel is.
Oh, she's fine. She's right here.
Can I speak to her?
Yes, hold on a minute. Holden.
Hello. Oh, Holden. Have you heard anything from Barkley?
No. But I think it's a good sign that it's taking so long. Your father must be listening seriously to what he has to say.
I hope so. Oh, I wanted you to know, I've been having a talk with your mama, and, well, she's convinced me that I have to try to find the courage to go into therapy.
Well, I'm glad to hear that, Angel.
And I want you to know that if I do start seeing Dr. Michaels, it will be as much for you and Lily as it is for me. I want to try to repay the help you've given me.
You don't have to pay us back. I know that everything's going to work out. For all of us.
When you compare chicken to chicken of the sea tuna, it's easy to see which one has more fat. Chicken of the sea tuna, half the fat of chicken.
Zing, zing, zing.
Dole Pure and Light.
Zing, zing, zing.
100% fruit juice in four unique flavors.
Zing, zap, zoom.
Delivers the exciting real fruit taste you've been waiting for.
It's Color Tile's President's Day Sale. Store-wide savings up to 67%. DuPont Stainmaster Carpet, incredible. Only $10.99 installed. And mini blinds, buy one, get two free. Tremendous reduction on ceramic floor and wall tile. Entire stock Armstrong no-wax floors, wood flooring, and wall covering too. So hurry. Save up to 67% at Color Tile's President's Day Sale. Sale ends Monday.
Double, double your refreshments.
double, double your enjoyment. Oh, no, single gum, double freshens your mouth like double mint, double mint gum. Double, double your refreshment. Double, double your delight.
There's no single gum like.
So, what was so important we couldn't discuss upstairs?
I got the feeling I upset you when you came by Wall
Street. I thought you had a big meeting now.
Well, my plans changed.
Really?
Yeah.
I don't see that happening to you very often.
What's that supposed to mean?
Well, I think you're a lady who likes to keep to a very tight schedule.
Why are you being so hostile? Look, I'm sorry about tonight. It's not as though we had definite plans, though.
No, but after last night, I was really looking forward to seeing you again.
So was I. But I told you, Lucinda came back unexpectedly. The entire office is in an uproar. I've got
okay,
so much
okay,
work
I can understand that. But when I stopped by to see you, I got the feeling you were very uncomfortable about my even being there.
You're wrong. Come on, I don't know why you're making such a big deal about this.
Look, I've been pretty straight with you. You know, it wasn't easy for me to let down my guard.
I know that. Link, that's why I was so happy about yesterday. I loved our ride and our dinner afterwards.
And how about our making it by the fire?
Well, yeah, I loved that too.
But it's over, so why talk about it, right? That was just something you worked at until you got it, and then once it was over, business as usual.
Where do you get off saying something like that to me?
I sensed it last night, but I tried to tell myself it was just my imagination. I could tell once we made it that you wanted me to get the hell out so you could go do whatever it is you wanted to do.
You're wrong.
No, it's okay. I understand that that's all sex is to some people. I've run into it before. But I don't usually come back for more.
Oh, yeah, so why are you here right now?
Because I thought that there might be something more between us. But I guess I was wrong. You don't want to be bothered with feelings or any kind of commitment.
You know, I really resent that. You have no idea what I think or what's going on inside me. You know, to be honest, Link, I think you're being a bit puritanical about last night.
Oh, I'll bet you do. The thing is, Connie, you want a relationship with absolutely no strings. And I'm looking for a whole lot more.
Well, why did Henry Lang cancel?
I don't know. Connor took that message. Is there anything else?
Yeah, you better bring me in all the riverfront property stuff. I have to look it over before I talk to Duncan McKechnie.
Well, if you don't need any more invaluable input from me, I think I will go to lunch.
Okay. When you're at M&A, picking up Ellie, please. Tell Lily that I am free for lunch now at whatever time
Lucinda?
She chooses, okay?
Lucinda, I have those two reports you wanted to see.
Put them on my desk, darling. I don't want to see them now.
No, stop. You can't go in.
Relax, Jane.
What's going on?
Lucinda,
okay,
Lang.
Wait.
Where's Henry Lang? He had a meeting here. I want to talk to him.
The meeting's canceled.
Why?
I have no idea. Possibly a better meeting elsewhere.
Caleb, I'm taking Ellie out to lunch. Why don't you join us?
No, no. I have something I have to do.
You okay?
What do you want with Henry Lang?
It's none of your damn business.
Look, I know Angel told you what's been going on lately, but I think the best thing for you to do is to just stay out of it.
Yeah, well, I don't take advice from you. Somebody's got to help Angel. You're so busy chasing Lily around, I guess it has to be me.
Liquid bleach cleans and whitens better than any detergent. No detergent alone cleans and whitens better. Clorox gets out the dirt detergents leave behind.
There's only one way to get a Clorox clean.
I can't fly with this head cold.
My nose is too stuffed up and congested.
Here, take Actifed.
For strong medicine, take full prescription strength Actifed. Of the three leading cold medicines once sold by prescription, only one comes in its original maximum full prescription strength formula. Only Actifed.
You okay?
Yeah, this stuff really works.
Take full prescription strength Actifed. And to help reduce the fever and sinus pain of a bad head cold, take Actifed Plus.
Mrs. Butterworth, let's make a commercial for your light syrup. You say, my light syrup's rich and delicious.
Then you say,
you really do talk.
My light syrup's delightfully thick, with almost half the calories of my regular syrup.
Mom, Mrs. Butterworth's talking.
I know, dear.
Mrs. Butterworth's light syrup.
You don't believe me, do you?
So light, yet so delicious.
And don't forget my regular syrup and pancake mix.
It's America's favorite tomato soup, plain and simple. And other ways. With Campbell's Tomato, the possibilities are endless.
So you want to be a cook? Make it shine.
No fumes easy off oven cleaner is heat activated. So there are no gloves, no harsh fumes.
No smell?
And no grease.
Not bad, kid.
No fumes easy off, the easy way out of a dirty oven.
Emma, can I help you with that?
No, everything's under control.
You know what I was thinking?
After lunch, why don't we go down to the pond and I'll teach you how to ice fish. We'll catch some little perch for supper, okay?
Right.
That'd be fun. You know, looking at that phone isn't going to make it ring.
Oh, I know. I'm just so worried about my brother.
Maybe that's Barkley now.
Oh, Angel.
Oh, hi, Cal.
Emma?
Oh, hello there. That was a pretty fancy knock.
Well, now that I'm a TV personality, I gotta have these little flourishes. Listen, I came to ask you if you found anybody to help replace the Petersons.
Well, I did put a notice up on the board. I just got one little call. I put a notice up at the Farmers Association board. You know, most of the people here are working in town to get through the winter. Mm-hmm. I don't know whether that'll work or not, but I'll keep on trying.
Well, I'd appreciate it.
We were just about ready to have lunch. Would you care to join us?
Well, I'd never turn down lunch. Two beautiful women.
Coat. Now, that's a Texan's way of saying yes.
Cal? Caleb told me that he was going into town to see you to talk about Julie. Did you see him?
Yeah, I saw him all right, but is there something bothering Caleb besides Julie? Because when I asked him if he'd come out here and help me with the books, why, he got all wild-eyed and said he couldn't because he had some business to do in town.
Excuse me, I'll be down in just a minute.
Henry Lang, please.
May I ask who's calling?
This is his son, Barkley.
I'm sorry, Mr. Lang's line is busy. Any message?
I'm on my way over to his suite now, but I've forgotten the room number. Could you give it to me, please?
It's 901, Mr. Lang.
Thank you.
Don't hurt your hair. Moisturize with Alberto.
Don't victimize.
Moisturize.
Don't agonize.
Moisturize!
Moisturize with Alberto Mousse for hold with softness and try our gel spritz and spray.
I love my boyfriend, but I go out with Alberto.
We're about to prove a simple point. On the left, a steak wrapped in saran wrap. On the right, both Reynolds and Glad wraps. Now, knowing a tiger won't eat what a tiger can't smell, which one do you think holds in odor and freshness better? Saran wrap.
My family loves egg noodles. But noodles are made with egg yolks, and egg yolks are loaded with cholesterol. So I found something different with no cholesterol. They're called no yolks. They look like regular egg noodles, taste like them too. But no yolks are better. They're made with only the egg whites, so there's no cholesterol. They're lighter and fluffier. They don't collapse and stick together. And no yolks taste terrific. So try them in your favorite noodle recipes. You'll like them. No yolks.
Diet tips from sugar-free Jell-O gelatin. Number one, watch what you eat. Two, count those calories.
8 calories, 8 calories, 8 calories.
Three, eat plenty of greens. Four, exercise, exercise, exercise. And remember, sugar-free Jell-O gelatin made with 100% NutraSweet has just 8 delicious little calories a serving. Oh, and if all else fails, form a support group.
There's always room for J-D-L-L-O.
Well, I just called to say goodbye, Franny, and have a good trip. Honey, I want to go back home more than anything. But no matter what I do, it doesn't seem to be enough. We're meeting with Dr. Matthews this afternoon. I know.
I'm glad I caught you before you left, because I think you misunderstood what I was saying to you this morning.
Oh, I probably did. I'm so confused about so many things in my life right now, and I'm very worried about Emily.
Maybe when you get out to Los Angeles, you'll find out that everything is okay, you know? Anyway, whatever I can do to help, please give me a call or something. Will you?
Well, you've given me the time off. That's a help. Thanks.
Good. I'm going to have some coffee. You want some? Come on, come on.
Sure.
Okay, kid. Have a wonderful trip. Bye-bye.
You know, I'm thinking of talking to Dr. Franz while I'm out in L.A.
You are? Well, I'll tell you something. I support you in whatever you do. You know that, okay? Here's to a happy trip. Happy landing. Oh, I gotta run. I'll drink this on the run. Have a good trip.
Hmm.
Were you really going to leave without saying goodbye to me?
Well, yes, I thought that's what you wanted.
Lucinda's back.
Oh, Kirk, I'm really sorry. I'm so sorry. What do you say we go for a nice lunch? That'll make you feel better, huh?
Yeah, thanks.
All right, great.
Hey, what's going on with Caleb? He came bursting into Lucinda's office looking for Henry Lang.
I really don't know. I tried to find out. I took him downstairs for coffee. I tried to get him to talk and open up to me, and he just stormed out. He's very angry. I think it has something to do with Angel.
Hmm.
I really do.
Hi. Hey,
hi.
Hold on. Is Lily here?
Yeah, she's in her office. Now, Kirk told me that Caleb came by Walsh looking for Henry Lang. I'm very worried about Caleb. What's going on with
him? Yeah, so am I.
Hold on, I thought I heard your voice. Barkley, have you heard from him?
No, I haven't.
Look, he came by Lucinda's office over an hour ago looking for you. I told him I thought you were over here.
He never came by? Well, obviously, there's a lot going on here, and you're not going to tell us, so I'm leaving.
I'm with her.
Something's wrong. He should have been here a long time ago. Barkley, where have you been?
I stopped by at Walsh, and Kirk Anderson said that you were here. I stopped to have a drink on the way.
Well, what happened with Henry?
He's going to Europe today. He won't see Angel, I pray.
Oh, Barkley, you did it.
Thank God. So why did you have to go have a drink? Has everything worked out the way we hoped for?
I don't expect you to understand this, but I kind of feel sorry for him. I never saw Dad give up before, but he just did.
Barkley, you did the right thing. You helped your sister out. Angel's safe now.
Please, operator, you don't understand. I'm Mr. Lang's daughter. It's urgent that I speak to him, please.
I'm sorry, your name is not on Mr. Lang's list.
Operator, I've got to speak to my father. It's a matter of life and death.
This is Mr. Lang. When Mr. Symington arrives, will you please have him come directly to my suite? Thank you. My son, when? Are you sure he said he was on his way? All right. Well, no, it's fine. Thank you. Thank you.
Barkley! Is that you?
Caleb, what are you doing here?
I want to talk to you, Henry.
I have nothing to say to you.
Maybe you should just listen for once in your life, then.
Get out of here. Where do I have to call security?
Still high and mighty? After what you did to Angel? Your own daughter? She told me the truth, Henry. I know what you are. Put down the phone, Henry.
Here, dear. Eat your oatmeal.
Gee, Mom, what's this?
Oatmeal Raisin Crisp.
Ah, neat.
It's oatmeal made just your way. Crispy flakes with oatmeal and a touch of brown sugar.
Gobs of raisins and almonds? I love Oatmeal Raisin Crisp. Look, Mom, I'm eating my oatmeal.
Oatmeal Crisp, Oatmeal Raisin Crisp.
Wait till I tell the guys.
Maybe now we should talk about finding you your own place.
You're on the go. That donut is tempting. Think.
Wow, I could have had a V8.
You go downstairs for that last piece of pie. Think.
Wow, I could have had a V8.
You're dying for a snack. You reach for those chips. Think.
Wow, I could have had a V8.
The time to think of having a V8 is before you have something else. V8 is a nutritious blend of 8 vegetable juices. Think. You could have had a V8.
Here's a cold medicine with a name you trust. Children's Tylenol Cold. Great, great flavor and all the relief he needs. Children's Tylenol Cold.
This antacid is recommended most by doctors. This antacid is recommended most by pharmacists. And this antacid is trusted by hospitals. So which should you use? Mylanta. For immediate relief, use the antacid doctors recommend most.
On a special night in time, a teenager in trouble.
Look, he's a decent kid.
But can a caring cop save him?
I'll kill you all!
Top Cops, tonight. On Guns of Paradise, the marshal decides between justice and giving up his badge.
You like to kill people. Kill me.
Next on Dallas, will JR make a move on his son's wife?
Just isn't any fun sleeping alone.
Then on Sons and Daughters, she's trying to spice up her marriage.
A 200-gallon sunken tub.
Before it goes bust. All on the Friday triple feature.
Later today, News 6 will report live from the trial of Jeffrey Cox, the man accused of murdering Eloise Cooper. Plus, we'll have the latest in the Charity Powers case. For complete details, watch live at 5.
Jewelry by Carol Lee Designs. Join us tomorrow for As the World Turns.